Hi, shalom, shalom from Israel. This is Ola, the daughter of Jethro. And I just heard that you black people that was stolen from Africa to America, that you don't know who you are, but you are the children of Yahweh, the children of Israel. And I'm telling you, you have to come back to your homeland, here to Zion, to Jerusalem, because us Gentiles, we do need you. We need you to come and pray because you are our saviors. You the one that was chosen by Yahweh to live in this land, not the Jewish people, it's you. You were stolen from Africa, they deceived you, they told you that you are slaves, but you actually the children of Israel. And it's time just to come back. Come for your people, come back for us, come back for the whole Gentiles, because only you. Only you gonna save us. So please come back to Zion.
Let me just reveal some things. First of all, is that the Jews who were brought in Israel, most of them are white. Not most of them, almost all of them are white, including me. I was brought in Israel from a country which is called Bulgaria. It's a European country. And I can tell you that in every European country, there are Jews and there is so-called organization, Jewish Agency, which is trying to take those Jews to Israel. If you track this organization, you can find out that this is not an Israeli organization, this is an American organization. Jewish Agency is an American organization which has the exclusive right to decide who is Jewish and who is not on this planet and who to be taken to Israel and who's not. Now, if you do research, you will find out that in Africa, in Black Africa, they're looking for Jews only in Ethiopia. They bring Jews only from Ethiopia. And I can tell you by knowing a lot of people, Ethiopian Jews here in Israel, that they're treated very badly, very badly. And many of them commit suicide because they cannot take it. So they come from some place, Ethiopia, they don't have much there, but they live decent life. And they, when they come here and try to be humiliated and so on, that some of them cannot even take it. Now, what I'm trying to say is that why from each white country this Jewish agency is trying to bring Jews, and when it's about Black Africa, they're going to Ethiopia, and this is where they stop, the only one place. Now, because of the same thing, they're trying to do the white supremacy here. They try to bring white guys here, and to take the supremacy over Arabs, which are the local citizens, and over blacks, which are, so far, they're only the Ethiopian Jews. Now, what I'm trying also to say is that another question is why? Why America needs Israel? There is no oil like in other Middle Eastern countries. There's no nothing they can be attracted to. But why do they do all these things? Why do they invest money, bring white people and so on? When they build their system of white supremacy, just like in America, they build in Israel. Why? And I can tell you why. Because the true Jews, according to the Bible, you can check it in the Bible, you can read Job 30:30 and some other places, they have never been white. They have been people of color. And they have not stopped in Ethiopia. They were in West, in Ethiopia, Sudan, and they have settled in West Africa. From West Africa, they have been taken as a slaves to America. Brothers and sisters, blacks of America, it's you. You are the true Hebrews. You are the true Hebrews from the Bible. America gonna do everything, gonna invest as much money as it has, gonna fight as much wars as they can, gonna invite as much weapons as they can just to hide this away from you. Gonna take Israel, gonna bring white people here and to tell you these are the Jews, gonna kill you, gonna kill Arabs, gonna mistreat white people like this guy just to tell you this lie, that you are nobody and we are the Jews with all the history and so on. It has been deleted, your history. You don't know who you are. Don't forget about it. This is why America has been taking your history away, never to find out that it's all about you. I'm telling you this, please, I don't ask you to come to Israel and to start a revolution. I'm just asking you to start thinking this way, to believe me a little bit, because I'm living in Israel and I'm part of this injustice. I really believe that people like me and you, we can bring the justice back. Thank you.
Now let me say something right quick. I think back on the African American people in America. I think how that they were taken against their wills, put in the belly of ships, brought over here, beat, cussed. Many of them died in the guts of those ships, thrown overboard. They were pulled from families over there. You ain't never heard a gut-wrenching song. You hear a black person sing one of those old black Negro spirituals. Nobody knows. I can't sing it like that, see, because I hadn't experienced what they be. When you've experienced hell, it comes out of the voice. I said, when you experience hell, it comes out of the voice. If you're one of those people that you got problem with black people or whatever, you better shut your mouth, because they're God's people. You better hear what I'm saying to you. You better shut your white mouth. You better shut your white mouth. I'm not kidding you. I know some of you is raised in the deep south and you is raised by prejudiced people and bigoted people. You better get that out of your system. You better get it out of your system. It'll cause you to suffer right along with those masters. It'll cause you to suffer right along with them. These are God's people. And I know that there's wicked in white races and wicked in black races and all that. I'm not justifying none of that stuff. I'm just saying God knows what happened to the black race. He knows how they wound up over here, and God is going to reimburse the black people for all their trouble and all their labor. You watch what I tell you. Watch what I tell you.
Deuteronomy 28, verse 68. The Lord will bring you back to Egypt in ships. By the way about which I spoke to you, you will never see it again. And there you will offer yourselves for sale to your enemies as male and female slaves, but there will be no buyer. There's definitely a lot of concepts and a lot of biblical truth to who the real Jews are. In the book of Revelation, we can see the seven churches of Revelation, right? The church of Smyrna talks about fake Jews. It's like 100 degrees in here, but it's interesting to talk about that subject because a lot of those biblical truths are not being taught to us in the pulpit. The Church of Smyrna talks about the fake Jews. And, you know, this prophecy here in Deuteronomy 28, verse 68, talks about who the true biblical Hebrew Israelites are and how they were going to be slaves for 400 years. Not in Egypt, but here in this country, in America, right? Shipped off in ships like a pack of sardine fishes. So yeah, you know, the biblical Hebrews, it's a very interesting topic when it comes to talking about the scriptures, and there's a lot of truth to those doctrines. You know, Jesus being portrayed as something that he's not over millennia has deceived a lot of people, right? Cesare Borgia and Da Vinci, right? Having sexual relationships and creating an idol of this false Jesus being portrayed in paintings. So, yeah, you know, in the book of Revelation, you can also see that there's an explanation of him having hair like wool and his appearance being like brass bronze, right? So we can see that Jesus was a man of color. And I think that that's something that a lot of people ignore, and it's not fair, right? Because this is an identity crisis too, as well, for the Hebrews, for the Jews. And it also involves prophecy today, in the day that we're living in, the day and hour we're living in. Yeah, so there's definitely different types of verses, and I think it's important to talk about this doctrine because it's something that a lot of people shy away from, and yeah, it's important to understand the truth of scripture in all its spheres, right?
Black Americans. He's, of course, expanded on Margaret Sanger's approach to eugenics, right? Eugenics was a movement that was born in the United States under hard doctrines of racism with the intent of eliminating the tribe of Judah in the African-American community in this country. With the intent of eliminating the tribe of Judah, the tribe of Judah, the tribe of Judah
in the African American community in this country,
right, to eliminate them. That's why she formed Planned Parenthood, was specifically to kill African American, Black Americans. That's why she did it.
All right, so this video is about Black people and how they're actually superior. Not just physically and all this and genetically and all that stuff, but actually they're the chosen people. Not all Black people, but a lot of them, and even I could say, I don't know if I could say most of them, but many of them. Specifically the people that are living in America, and specifically the people who have been sent all over the earth on slave ships, those people are superior, even in the Most High's eyes himself, because those people are the Israelites. And there's a scripture that says, not only says if you bless them, you'll be blessed. There's also one that says you have to cling to them or you can't even be saved. So for one, that means acknowledging who they are, obviously. And for two, it means reading even their own scriptures, because these scriptures are not for everyone. They're for them. And if you want to follow after their God,
you so-called Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are the biblical Israelites, according to the curses of Deuteronomy 28. What I want to go into today is show that Christ does have a color, and that Christ is, according to the Bible, a black man. He is not a white man, as the Christian church teaches and has deceived the whole world to follow after the image that the Bible calls the image of the beast. But he is indeed a black man. I want to read out of Jeremiah in the King James Version, of which King James himself was a black man. And I want to read chapter 14, verse 2. It reads as follows. Judah mourneth, and the gates thereof languish. They, Judah, are black unto the ground, and the cry of Jerusalem is gone up. I had to learn this myself, but the word Jew comes from the word Judah. And the white people in Israel right now, claiming to be Jews, say they are Jewish. Ish, the suffix ish, means of or pertaining to, similar to. They wish they were the Jews, but they know that they are not the real Jews. I also want to go to Hebrews, and we could do this all day long, showing that Christ is a black man and not a white man and not a chameleon, as the Christian church, the modern day Christianity has called, they as soon as you prove that he's black, they say, well, he's invisible, or he can change to whatever color he wants to be. Christ had a body, and Christ had a color. Christ came from the tribe of Judah. In Hebrews chapter 7, verse 14, it says, for it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah, of which no tribe Moses spake, of which tribe Moses spake nothing concerning priesthood. So it is evident that Christ sprang from the tribe of Judah. Judah is the strongest tribe. It is the head tribe of all Israel. So of course, Christ would spring out of the tribe of Judah through the lineage of David. And David's lineage does not come forward to Mary. Christ had an earthly father as well. David's lineage comes forward to Joseph. So Joseph was Christ's earthly father. But just like they try to tear the black family apart, today they try to do the same thing in the Bible. They try to separate the man from the woman. And they've done the same thing with Christ's earthly family, with his mother and his father. Now I want to go to Revelation chapter 1, and I'm going to start at verse 14. First of all, the book of Revelation, the root word is to reveal. So Christ is about to be revealed. Why is he about to be revealed? Because God knew that in the end times, of which we are in, that should be obvious, that my people, the powers that be, would come up with a white image, and that they would convince the entire world that he is the image of Christ, when he is not. But I'm going to start at verse 14. Revelation 1, Revelation chapter 1, verse 14. It says, his head, in other words, the hair on his head, and his hairs, his beard were white. So Christ was fully gray. He was white-headed. And then it gives you the texture, like wool. There's only one nationality of people on the face of the earth that have woolly hair. It says that his hair was white like wool, as white as snow, fully gray. It says, and his eyes were as a flame of fire. Because Christ drank wine in moderation. If you go back and you read concerning, it says when Shiloh comes, which Shiloh is Christ, it says that his eyes would be red with wine in Genesis, I believe, chapter 49, verse 12. It tells you. So no, Christ was not shooting laser beams out of his eyes. Christ did not have literal flames in his eyes. Christ drank wine. And when black people drink wine, their eyes turn red. The whites of their eyes turn red. It says, verse 15, it says, and his feet like unto fine brass. Brass is brown, as if they burned in a furnace. If you want to see what color brass turns when you put it in a furnace, go on Google and look it up. It gets very dark. So Christ was a very dark-skinned black man with white woolly hair and red eyes, because Christ drank wine in moderation, not to get drunk. It says, and his voice as the sound of many waters, letting you know that Christ spoke loudly. Christ was a very austere man. Christ was not the punk that they have portrayed him to be in all of these movies, the effeminate image that they have given us. That's not how Christ acted. And just in case you want to get simple and say that this image is not literally how Christ looked, Let's read Revelation 1 and start at verse 10, because John the Revelator saw Christ when Christ was on the earth as a man. So he knew what Christ looked like. Revelation chapter 1, verse 10. This is John the Revelator who saw Christ speaking. I was in the Spirit on the Lord's day and heard behind me a great voice as a trumpet, loud, saying, and this is Christ speaking, I am Alpha and Omega, the first and the last. What thou seest, write in a book and send it unto the seven churches which are in Asia, unto Ephesus and unto Smyrna and unto Pergamos and unto Thyatira, and unto Sardis, and unto Philadelphia, and unto Laodicea. Then John says, and I turned, so John turned around to see the voice that spake with me. So he turned to see who was speaking to him. He turned to look at him. And being turned, I saw seven golden candlesticks. And in the midst of the seven candlesticks, let's see what he saw. One like unto the Son of Man. Christ is the Son of Man because Christ came through the seed of man, through the lineage of David. Christ had an earthly father. He was not immaculately conceived. That is nonsense. So John, who had seen Christ when Christ walked the earth as a man, he turned to see the voice that spoke with him, and he saw someone that looked like Christ. So obviously he recognized him as Christ. So this is not a different version of Christ, a different looking image of Christ. It is still Christ. And there are many other verses that you can go to. The fact that you go to Deuteronomy chapter 1, verse 1, it tells you that Moses is speaking to the Israelites. Then you read that the Israelites went into slavery on cargo slave ships. Who are the people that went into slavery on cargo slave ships? The so-called blacks, the so-called Hispanics, the so-called Native Americans. One of those tribes is the tribe of Judah, the American blacks. So to say that Christ is white when he is clearly black is nonsense. This is just deception by my people and lies to hide because they know how important it is. They know how important the real Jews are, and they have done everything that they can to hide their identity from them and to cut them off from being a nation. So with that, I see that my video is getting long. I may not even be able to upload this. I may have to redo this. Hopefully not. But with this, I'm gonna end the video and I'm gonna say shalom, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you.